Hey guys, my name is Soj. We're gonna walk you through how to make a cereal box guitar. You're gonna use any type of cereal box that you have around the house. You'll need some tape. Today I'm using duct tape. It has gummy bears on it, but you can use any type of colorful tape that you have. Just some regular old scotch tape. I'm using 6 rubber bands that'll go the length of the cereal box, but you can use 4 or even just 2 if you want. We're gonna need a Sharpie and a cup that you're gonna trace the circle from, as well as something sharp to cut the circle with and some scissors to cut the circle in half. So here we go. Make sure you have a parent or someone that can help you with the sharp things. And here we go. Okay, so we have here a taped top. Right, so we'll need both sides of the box fastened shut. You can use your colorful tape at the top if you'd like, or you can color the top of the tape before you put it on, just to make it yours. We have cut a circle from a glass, and here's the circle. We're gonna cut it in half first, but before you do that, let's try and clean it up a little bit. Next, we are going to cut this circle in half. And so what this does is gives us a nut. This is called the nut on an acoustic guitar. And then also we're gonna cut a strip that's gonna give us the bridge up top. And so this enables these strings to be kind of like free floating from the box itself. All right. We have here a strip. Here's a strip and the half circle. So what we're gonna do is put the strip at the top at one end and then the half circle around the base of the hole that we've created. Okay. And then in order to lift these up, we're going to cut the rest of the circle in half like so. Okay, and we're gonna fold them in a little bit to kind of create a platform. Right, and so we're going to then tape the bottom of it to either one of your surfaces here. Okay, like so, and so that'll raise it up just a little bit. Okay, so now that we have both ends fastened, I've used regular scotch tape underneath and also kind of over the top because it's clear to hold it down. This kind of gives us a raised platform for the rubber bands to go over. So all you're gonna do is adjust one over like so. And give us some room. A little bit so that we can get 5 more over. All right, so now that we have our 5 or 6 over them, I want to make sure that our rubber bands aren't gonna move at all. So we're gonna fasten them on either end, because right now you can kind of strum it, but it doesn't make very much noise. You could also, if you'd like, you can raise the rubber bands a little bit more so that they have more leeway. But for right now, let's just try and fasten them on either end. And so I'm just going to use my duct tape again. Alright, there you have it. We have a cereal box guitar. You can play it. It's upside down. You can play it like this, right? Right? Doesn't get too much of a tone, but you can use it however you like. It's mainly just to practice strumming and adjusting your fingers on a single string. Alright, and it looks super cool. So enjoy your new cereal box guitar, and I'll see you next time. Bye.